I do use 755 as well for pigmented lesions. If you had a Becker's nevi that was biopsied and determined safe to be removed, I would use it there. I might use it in a café au lait birthmark. I might use it for just some pigmented areas of PIH even would be any use of it.
So before we get started, make sure that the skin is clean. I usually have my patients cleanse their face first and wash their whole face with a mild soap. And then I also wipe off the skin of any residual oils and residue with an alcohol wipe. And then be sure that the skin is totally dry before we start the laser treatment. For pigment, I typically recommend using a pretty low pulse width because pigment is very superficial. And then because Darian here is roughly a Fitzpatrick type 2 skin type, I'm going to use an energy level or fluence that is towards the higher end of the recommended settings in the manual because she's pretty fair-skinned, and fair-skinned people can actually tolerate the laser more so than skin of color. And so I can use a bit of a higher setting for the fluence or for the energy. So we're gonna get started. And I'm gonna have you put on these safety goggles. I'm gonna start on your left cheek. So turn to your right just a little bit. Okay. I'm gonna adjust the goggle just a little bit here. Okay, here we go. So what I'm doing is actually treating the entire surface area of the face. You can spot treat brown spots or hyperpigmentation, but I have found in my experience that it just works better to treat the entire face. And then you actually end up getting areas where you didn't even know pigment was there to come out. Now, if you can turn to your right a little bit, good. So the clinical endpoint that you want to look for when treating brown spots is a slight darkening of the brown spots that may or may not be seen for a few minutes after the treatment, but that's the endpoint that we're looking for, and that shows that it's actually working. So Darian, how does your skin feel right now?
It feels warm, a little hot.
Okay.
Like a sunburn.
Okay, good.
Which I haven't had for a long time.
Well, that's normal. So your face is going to feel like a mild sunburn for probably up to a couple hours or a few hours, okay. 2 to 3 hours, let's say, and then it should go away. And that's totally normal. Okay. If it's uncomfortable, you can certainly take some Tylenol or some ibuprofen and for the discomfort. Mm-hmm. And the brown spots have gotten darker, which is also normal. And they may continue to get a little bit darker until this evening. And that's normal. They actually get worse before they get better. And then you can see a bit of a coffee ground appearance, like little dark spots. Okay. And that's normal as well. And over about the next week or so, those dark spots just slough off. You can use your regular skincare regimen. So you can use your normal face wash, your normal face lotions and moisturizers. And definitely I recommend an SPF daily moisturizer on your face for sun protection.
Okay.
All right, do you have any questions?
No, I think you've covered all of them.
Okay, great.